I'd like to welcome everybody to the meeting, September meeting of McEwen Mayor Board and Mayor. Welcome all citizens. At this time, we'd like to ask Reverend Joan Hubbard of the McEwen United Methodist Church to lead us in prayer.
Mayor Ross and council members, I thank you for the opportunity to be here. I want to remind you that you are a select group. The people of this community have elected you because they have confidence in you and they know that you will lead us to do great things here in this little corner of our world. So I pray that as you do make these decisions, some of them may be hard, but we know that you will do the right thing. Psalms number 1 says, "Blessed is the person that walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, or stands in the ways of sinners, or sits in the seats of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of God, and in his delight will he meditate. And he'll be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper." We want to prosper here in McEwen, and we know that you'll lead us towards that. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray that these, your community leaders, will be blessed as they pursue to lead us into the future. Help them to remember that they'll have to answer to a higher power for the decisions that they make. Give them courage to stand for what is good and right, and bless them with wisdom as they make their decisions, to remember that we are working together to build a future for future generations, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Hubbard. Thank you very much. Is everybody about ready to go ahead, Johnny? Go ahead, take time, buddy.
Don't let me stop.
Okay. We'll have the minutes read for the August 11th meeting. We don't need to read them, I'm sorry. Vicki got ahead this time, she's smart and sent them all out, so everybody that had them at home, if you haven't read them, that's tough. We need a motion to approve and a second, please.
I make a motion to approve the minutes of the last meeting.
All right, motion has been made to approve the minutes of the August 11th meeting. We need a second.
Second.
Second's been made. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much. Yeah, I've already looked at the bill, and I think everybody here has looked at them. Anything come to your attention? Anything draw your attention to ask any questions? If not, we need to approve and second there.
I make a motion to pay the bills.
Motion's been made to approve the bill. Pay the bills.
Second.
Second's been made. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much. First thing we have on the old business now. This has been old business ever since I've been mayor. This is the third meeting. This is the clinic and Dr. Yancey. Dr. Yancey and I talked, and I've been down there several times. He's been up here, I've been down there again, he's been up here, I've been down there. We're not getting anywhere. He does not want to pay any more rent. He says he can't afford any more rent. So I'm proposing something here, and we'll see what the board wants to do about it. I know Dr. Yancey is a valuable asset to the community. A lot of people go to it, and I've told him. He asked me why I want to get rid of him. I don't want to get rid of him. I just like to get some money out of him. He's been working in the city building for 28 years free. We've got two more clinics in McEwen where they have to pay rent, and it's just not fair. And we don't need to table this again. We need to take some action, I think. What I recommend, and what I did talk to him about, he's willing to pay the $350 a month, which Johnny and Mr. John Lee Williams and myself wanted to go up on it, but he says he can't do that. So he's willing to pay $350 a month and pay when he can toward fixing inside, interior up. Now, I propose he pay $350 a month, and he owes the city $9,800 for the 28 months, minus what we figure in for a central unit that was put in. That's $9,800 that he should have to pay the city, I propose, plus $350 a month. The $9,800 would in turn go back into fixing the building up on the inside. I don't know how many people have been down there, but it's deplorable. You'll step through a floor, you can put your finger through a wall, it's just terrible. Three bathrooms and one works, and you wouldn't want to use it. But these are things that he's supposed to take care of and hasn't done, and like I say, he says he will as he can. But now I'm open for suggestions. Anybody got any ideas what we can do about this? It's time, I think, that we did something, though. And I'm not trying to run him off, don't get me wrong. But we need to do something. He does owe about $9,800. And we'd put that toward, like I say, we'd put that toward fixing it back up on the inside. It's going to be, the walls are going to be redone and painted. The floors are going to be redone. Everything stripped up. Lots and lots of plumbing. If you had a fire in the front, had the exit out the back, you couldn't get out. So has anybody got any ideas? Do you want to go with my proposal? Anybody got any different ideas, a different figure? Would you like for him to have to pay less up front instead of the 98? I think he should have to pay the city so much up front toward the restoration of the building.
Will he be allowed a time frame for that?
We're going to give him 6 months. Now, he's not agreeable to this. As of now, he's not agreeable to this amount at all. But I think if we lay the law down and make it clear to him, that's the way it's going to be. If he doesn't want to do it, we got other people that are wanting to go in the clinic. So, anybody?
What about the continued improvement to the building there after the? With a $350 a month, what would be expected as far as continued improvement to repairs to the building?
Well,
$9,800 is not going to fix it.
No, it's going to take about $30,000 or better to fix the building.
What are we going to do about that?
That $350 a month, of course, that's going toward rent. The $9,800 would go toward the $30,000 or whatever it takes to fix it, but the rest of it, I think he should have to pay. That was the original plan for him to pay it. I don't think if the city has to pay that, he shouldn't be in there. We'll fix it up for somebody else.
And you deducted the amount that you feel was already put into the building?
For the unit, yes. Now, it was said, he's told me that the city, and Mr. Etheridge knows about this, I think, you do maybe too. I looked it up and I got the facts straight. He told me that the city didn't do their part. The city agreed to take care of the outside. Well, the city has taken care of the outside. And we pay the utilities, we mow the yard and everything. But we did not pave the parking lot. But the agreement was the city would pave the parking lot once the city started paving again. The city has not paved yet. And we're not going to pave complete roads till we get these water and sewer lines fixed, because that's ridiculous. So he doesn't have us there at all. He's drawing his strings there, just grasping his strings, you know. Anybody got any ideas at all, just throw them out there on the floor. We'll work on anybody.
There you go. I'll spend a day down there helping him paint. I'll donate the paint in my time. One day I'll go down there and paint anything inside. If he's got a room clean, he is an asset in this community. I hate to see him go.
Well, I do too, Mike. But, you know, we can't put up with this anymore. Most cities wouldn't put up with it this long. 28 months. That's ridiculous. And I've tried, well.
What did he say about the $9,800? Did he say he'd pay that?
No, sir.
Sounds like a liability. it sounds like a liability to me. I mean, that sounds like we're in dangerous territory with this.
Thank you much, thank you.
How much would he be expected in addition to the paying the rent in the way of improvement to the building over a period of time? And how are we going to make sure that that's done?
Well, the amount wise, we'll just have to take bids for as far as the amount that it actually costs. Myself and a couple other people, if we just what you call guesstimated $30,000. It may be a little less, it may be a little more, but it's pretty close. And I'm saying that you know, if he's willing to pay the $9,800 and pay the $350 a month, I wouldn't mind if the $350 a month went toward the renovation of the building instead of the rent. But as soon as we got the thing fixed, or he got it fixed, and we would do regular, myself and whoever would go with me from the city, we'd go down there and check it on a monthly basis, and we better see improvements every time, or we'd cut the deal off. But if he pay the $9,800, pay $350 a month, we'll put that towards the renovation of the building, and when he gets it all fixed, then he'll just pay $350 a month. I think that's fair. But if somebody thinks the $9,800 is too much to ask off the bat, speak up. I don't think $350 is too much to ask for rent now.
I think Mr. Hendricks.
I was going to say, following up on John's question, I think what I'm hearing from John is there a list of what he is going to do? I mean, is there, you know, that he's expected to do 1 through 10? Or is there not a list?
No, there's no list as of right now.
Well, I think you would benefit from having a list of what he's supposed to do in some kind of time frame.
Well, there's not an official list. I do have a list of the city employee, and I went down there for an inspection, and we made a list of everything that needed to be done. So I guess you could say the list, but not officially.
Yes.
He was with us when we took the tour and everything, so he knows what we wrote down.
Well, I'd make him sign that list. So that he's going to put his $9,800 toward, you know, getting that stuff done.
Well, he won't do that.
Why not?
He says he hadn't got the money.
Keep him out.
He broke it.
I think somebody would pay the rent.
Well, my first idea is to tell him to hit the road and get somebody to pay the rent. But he is an asset and he's helped a lot of people. But the thing is, he's told me he's done so much free work and he doesn't get paid for. But when you're paying rent to somebody, you're supposed to be paying rent to somebody, you better be charging somebody or else have a pocket full yourself. Because that's not treating the city right. And the city of McEwen has been on the short end of the stick long enough. It's time for the citizens to see something done and the board to do it. And if he has to go, he has to go. I don't want him to, but if he won't agree to this, I think we should, he's ready to walk out the other day. But he wasn't willing to pay anything.
Well, it's no different from any of us having a house note. And if we don't have a house note, the bank's going to keep us out or the mortgage company, you know. And it would be our own fault if we didn't pay it.
Yeah, this is his possibility.
So if he walks out, it's all on us.
Well, I don't think we should allow him to walk out and it all be on us. He should have to make some kind of restitution here for the way the building, the shape it's in. You know, I don't think we should let him off scot-free. Because he'll move to another place to do the same thing. And, you know, that leaves us in the hole. We've got to pay $30,000 or $40,000 to get it fixed for somebody else to come in. Yeah. Or else let somebody use it rent-free for 5 years while they fix it up. And we're still coming out in the hole.
Cecil, what has been his reasoning for not fixing it up?
No money.
As full as he stays.
He stays full, but he claims he does everything just about free. And I've talked to some people that he has helped. I'll give him credit for that. He has helped some people. But I just can't believe he hadn't got anything, and, you know, I can't believe he couldn't pay the $350. And he's let this go since midnight, May the 14th at midnight, 2013. He's let this go, hadn't paid any rent. And in 28 months' time, he should have been had at least had improvement done. If he couldn't pay the rent, he should have made improvements. He should have come to the people that were on the board at the time. He should have come to y'all and said, I cannot pay the rent and renovate the building. I'll renovate the building, get in good shape, and then I'll start paying rent. And I think you would have gone along with it, and I think you would have gone along with it. But it just kind of slid through somewhere.
What type of improvements would he be responsible for?
Anything
upon $350 a month, if he's paying that, what in addition to that would he be responsible for? If we're going to put the money in to put it back into the clinic.
Well, all the $350 go back into the clinic.
What else would he be responsible for as far as upkeep of the building? If he paid a fee back to the city for the back rent, would he be responsible for any other improvements to the building?
If he paid the back rent, he would have to have the building back in top shape. I mean, he'd have to. And that $350 a month would go toward that. If he had to pay $350 more on a loan to get it fixed back up, he'd just have to pay it.
But would he be responsible for anything other than the $350 a month after that point?
After we get it fixed up?
Right.
No. I think after he got it paid and had it fixed up until the board go down or whoever's on the board at the time, this may be 30 years down the road. I'm not gonna be here.
But
I am. I don't know who I am. I'm not sure now.
Between now and the time it is fixed to the city's satisfaction, and he pays $350 a month, will he be responsible for other repairs out of pocket to that building during that time frame, or are we going to use that money solely to fix it up?
Yeah, we're going to use that money solely to fix it up.
Okay. Would he be responsible for any other out of pocket expenses upon paying the rent?
Well, just anything that popped up during that time. I mean, the condition of the building is so bad that since our first inspection down there, right as you go in the double doors to go back to the doctor's office, the little rooms where you wait, waiting rooms, I guess you'd call them, waiting rooms, the floor is buffed up. You can't open the door all the way. On the other side of the door, the floor's dropped down. So, you know, you got a mountain here and a mold hole here. And he'd have to fix that. He said we were responsible for that. But the way I read it, anything inside that building, he's responsible for keeping up. And so he will be responsible for repairing. That's my suggestion. Plus paying the, I'm just saying 98, that's a figure that he actually owes. If somebody wants to recommend something less to help him out so he can do this, we'll discuss that. But we need to do something. He's been pulling my leg, too long. One of them long enough than now. But we need to do something.
Cecil, I don't think if he can't pay $350 in rent or hasn't been paying rent, I don't know how he can come up with $9,800. Is there something that we could possibly say, overlook that $9,800 and start charging rent and he has to fix everything up? Would he be willing to do that?
Yeah, he said he'd be willing to pay the $350 and fix it up as he could. But that as he could is, that's a big trouble.
Well, that would have to be monitored.
We'd have to give him a limit. We'd have to give him 12 months.
Right, right.
Could we do like a 12-month evaluation and every 12 months examine what's been done and probably... be given a list of what needs to be done in 12 months.
Like Mr. Hendricks, Mr. Clinton, Mr.
Instead of just letting it up to him.
About a list. We do have a list.
We can come up with a list. Bart mentioned that a while ago. That's a pretty good idea.
Well, we can't review it every 12
have to
months.
You'd have to go sooner than that.
We'd have to go every month often. And keep up. Yeah. I suggest
it. Yeah.
We go every month. And something should be accomplished. We'll document what's shape it's in now, and at the end of the month, we'll document what's been done. 12 months, in 12 months period, everything, he should have accomplished a lot. But I don't think we should let him out of paying some of this 28 months. Now, if you don't want him to pay all this $9,800, if you think that's too harsh, So we'll figure it out, $9,750.
Well, I don't have a figure, but I just, if he can't, if he says he says he can't pay the rent, which I don't think that's the case.
Yeah.
But if that were the case, then there's no way he can pay the $9,800. So that's why I was asking, would he be willing to pay, start paying rent and then fixing it all up?
He says he will, but like I said, he'll pay the $350. We wanted, Mr. John Lee Williams and myself talked, and wanted him to pay $1,000, anywhere from $750 to $1,000. Well, he just about had his suitcase back then. But he said he would pay the $350 a month and fix the interior up as he could. Now, that's based on his opinion when he can, not ours. Mm-hmm. I like this.
Thank you, be willing.
McDonald thinks, and I think that John thinks, and myself think, we should check every month to make sure he's made improvements and give him a year to get these improvements made.
If we were to waive the $9,800, as Kim had mentioned, and he would be put that $9,800 back into that building over a 12-month period, and it'd be checked by the city every month to see that the improvements are made, and then resume paying a $350 a month rent to the city faithfully.
Well, that's what we said. We'd put the
$9,800 back in. Instead of paying it monetarily, have the man put it back into the repairs and upkeep of the building, and he'd be told what the city expects.
Exactly. He needs to be given a list.
Needs to be
a specified list and a time limit to have that done, and we need to check on him.
Check on him, make sure like it's supposed to be done.
Yes.
And who's going to account for the money? Who's going to account for the $9,800?
He would have to show proof to the city. Invoices, labor bills, whatever.
Receipts, copies of receipts.
He's going to have to keep track of that.
Yeah, we need copies of receipts.
I think people that were asking were giving too much leeway on him on that. Honestly, I do not think the man can be trusted to do that. He may have good intentions, but I just don't think that we'll see the results that we want in a 12-month period. But, you know,
when he paid rent before, he paid $550.
Yeah, he was paying $550. Yeah, he paid $350.
He has a better deal.
I think he ought to pay some back. I don't know if he can, I would say he needs to pay the whole $9,800 right now, but I think he needs to pay something.
Well, that's why I say, y'all come up with a number. But I think he should pay that. I don't care if he has to go borrow the money. Everybody in here has borrowed money at some point to buy something, old fish or a lawnmower or something. That's true. But, yeah,
I mean, if he's helped out so many people, maybe they can come together and help him out and work on the building.
They may do it. Mr. Hooper here said he's willing to go down there and pay for that.
I charge $9,800 to pay my room.
Help for free.
Mr. Hooper, that's going to Mr. Hooper out, wouldn't it? But if you want to go less than $9,800, then we'll just, like I say, he can go to the bank and borrow or something. I think we're going to have some money up front to show good faith on his part. And he'll be out that much if he decides not to do anymore.
He's not paid anything for 2 years. I think he needs to pay something.
That also goes back to the last mayor in there, too. The last mayor should have presented something before
now.
Yeah. And like she said, it shouldn't have got this far behind to begin with.
I agree. No, we didn't do that. We can stop it now.
Right.
And I think it's time to do it. $7,500, $8,000, $7,000.
I'd go work for y'all. If you're not behind that much, I'd go work for y'all. If you don't like it, you hit the road.
The way you interest.
Well, I've thrown it out there for $9,800. That's what I'm asking for. Him to pay $9,800 and $350 a month, and all that go back into the renovation building. Now, if y'all want to change the $9,800 price or anything else, somebody speak up. But I don't think we need to let him off scot-free enough. And he needs to pay it back. And Vicki put it in the account for it. You know, we don't need him to keep up with how much he's paying, how much he's putting into it. Because something could cost $300, he could put down $750. And in my dealings with a man, I would question what he put down. So
you're saying to not have him do repairs and pay for it out of his pocket, you're saying have him bring money to City Hall until he pays the debt? Is that what you're saying?
I'm not sure what I said.
Unless it's
that right. I knew all
ago. Is he supposed to put the $9,800 back into the building with receipts for the next year? Or is he supposed to do? Oh,
we'll do. We'll do.
Owe you $9,800 now.
No, he needs to put $9,800 to us. He needs to give $9,800 to us now. That's what he's behind. That's what any of y'all would have to do if you were behind on anything to keep your car, your truck, your toilet, or whatever. You'd have to pay $9,800. And I think he's no different than we are on the city building. That's just a city building.
Yeah.
But and, the city can spend the money to get the repairs done. Not all on him.
The city.
I'm not going to pay my water bill for 28
months. You'll be down behind the iron bars, Missy.
So why
can't
my
name be? Mr. Henders, what do you say? Us make the payments on the renovation?
Well, if he's going to pay the city the $9,800 back, you're going to put it in the building, then, and it's a city building, and seeing the city would then oversee the repairs, and he would leave Yancey out of it. Just take the money that he pays and then
that way you would get an $800 when it's more required.
Exactly. Yeah. And you could get the best price for the repairs.
And probably get it done quicker.
Actually, I mean, Jesse's a pretty good caller. You buy $9,800 and
get a new building.
Send a couple up down there.
What's going to take more than $9,800 right. though, right?
Yeah, it's going to take more than
$9,800.
But it'll get you pretty far. Yeah, that would be a good dent, I would think.
$9,800 would be a major improvement.
Mm-hmm. But now you're back to Yancey saying he doesn't have any money. So how are you going to get $9,800 out of somebody that's going to be broke? And how much time are you going to give him to say, I can't get it to you?
Exactly.
If you give him another year, he ain't got no value when you're behind another year.
We can't give him a year. I'm hoping that if we throw this to him and make it clear to him that he has to pay $9,800 up front, plus the $350 a month, and that'll go into the story. That he'll come up with it, get him any way he can. If he doesn't, I say we help him out. Not help him out the door. Make him pay something. We just cannot let him off scot free. It's just not right.
No.
It's just not right to citizens of McEwen. Citizens of McEwen have been had it put to them long enough. Let's stop it.
Well, eventually somebody's going to step to the floor and break their leg, and then the city's going to be liable.
You're right on that one side.
You're going. That's there.
He mentioned that liability on that, and about that, about the floor. It is rotten on one side, and on the other side, it's got a hump that big, and can't open the door. So, I mean, it's just in bad shape. But we need to...
You couldn't like, tell him $450 a month, and you got to give him that list, and tell him you got 6 months to do this list. Mm-hmm. And then, I mean, at the end of the year, at extra $100 a month, you have your $9,000 back, wouldn't work. Or no, extra, no, I guess that wouldn't work. I'm thinking $100 is about $1,000.
See what?
What do y'all think, Donna?
Mm-hmm.
I'm with charging him the rent. I'm with making him pay.
What amount do you want him to pay? Y'all got a different idea than the $9,800?
So you base that on the $350 that you want for rent back 2 years, is that right?
28 months, right.
28 months?
Minus the central unit he had put in.
So who pays the insurance on this building?
I see it McEwen because it's a city building.
If someone gets hurt, negligence, and sue us, it's going to take, you're going to lose more than $9,800. So he's got no money. He hasn't paid any rent. I don't know the gentleman. This is the problem, and we need to end it.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Anybody else in the audience got anything to say? Anybody got any solutions? Well, I got one. I told you mine, so.
Well, I think you ought to tell him to pay the $9,800, pay $350 a month rent, and if he doesn't agree to that or can't do that, then I'm sorry, we'll see you later.
If you've got somebody else wanting to move into the building, we've got two other clinics here in town.
But the building's still gonna have to be fixed before somebody else moves in, or you're gonna have these same problems.
Yeah, it's gotta be fixed, you're right, it's gotta be fixed.
I think he needs to pay the back rent too, before he leaves.
Yeah, I don't think he, yeah, I don't want him to get out, if he leaves, I don't want him to get in town, not paying anything.
Put a lien on or something.
What do you say, John?
Well, I threw an idea out. What y'all wanna do? Wanna do it with improvement, or wanna do it monetarily?
I think monetarily.
Okay.
That's my opinion.
Do we wanna come down with a $9,800, or do we wanna do a lesser amount?
I honestly don't see a lesser amount for sure. If you calculate $350 a month for 28 months, you're going to get $9,800.
Yeah.
But if he wants, I would suggest that if anybody else wanted the building and the city's already fixed it up, that the rent be higher than $350.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. That'd be higher than $350.
For sure.
Well, that's what started all this. I hit him up to start paying rent again after 28 months, and I hit him up for $750, and that's when it just went wild. I've met with him three times, been down there, and he's been up here, and he just keeps on giving me the same sad tale. He's got no money. I don't either, but.
If he doesn't have any money, how does he pay the people that work for him?
He claims he doesn't.
They work for free?
He claims he worked for free, and one lady, I'll go into one thing that's told me, but that's private, but he claims that they don't, he doesn't pay them.
Well, then they're crazy.
I don't believe that for a minute.
Ma'am?
I don't believe that for a minute.
That don't happen these days, does it?
Well, he's a mighty good fella, is all I know. If he does all that. It's okay. I've given suggestions, John's given suggestions, both of you have said something. Johnny, you got anything to say about it, buddy?
No.
Do you think he should have to pay
something? Yeah, I think he should have to pay something.
Plus the $350.
If he can, but if he can't, he don't want to pay nothing, he don't want to continue in the business and keep it up. You just have to let him go. Hate to lose him.
Well, I do too. You know, he questioned me why. He said, nobody has ever bothered me before. Why are you trying to get rid of me? Why are you against me? Well, it's because of, I'm not going into that. We're trying to take control. We're trying to get the city back in shape. This is one step we can make right here. This is a big step. This is a big step in showing the citizens here that we do care about what happens in this city. That we're not going to let people get away with nothing. I mean anything, but excuse me. We're not going to let people get away with anything. If they owe us money, they're going to pay us money. We cut off water every month. Bunches of them. Cut off water. And then we cut them back on when they pay. So I don't think we should let him get away with it. And yes, I think he should have to pay some money up front. The amount, y'all can set the amount if you want to. I'm firm on the $350, no less than $350. My opinion. But let's get something going here now. Come on.
I've already agreed. Okay. I'm okay with it.
Agree with him.
Okay, let's get the figures out now. We're gonna ask him to pay $350 a month, and that money go back into the restoration of the building. And we're gonna ask him to pay $9,800. No, we're not gonna ask him, we're gonna tell him he gotta pay $9,800. We don't ask people to pay the bill, we tell them to pay the bill. So we're gonna tell him to pay $9,800. I do have a list of preparers.
He has to have a deadline for that.
Yeah, we're gonna have to have a deadline, yeah. When you want the deadline. Then we're gonna have to have monthly inspections. I'll go and so I'll have somebody with me. How many?
What do you think?
I think you need to start immediately.
Oh yeah.
On the rent, definitely. Yeah. But on the big $9,800. He needs a deadline to have that paid by.
Well, like Cecil said, I mean, if we're going to say $9,800, I'm sure he's got the credit to go to the bank.
Yeah.
30 days, 60 days, what?
30 days is the very most, I'd say.
Sounds reasonable.
He could get, you know, if he's got any credit at all, he can get a loan in 30 days for $9,800.
Okay, 30 days. Is that good?
Okay, we're going to make him pay $9,800 to the city, pay $350 a month until we get it all fixed. And then he just pays $350 a month. And we'll continue to take care of the mower on the outside of the building.
And when we begin paving again one day, his parking lot.
40 years down the road, when we pave again.
When they come.
We'll pave his parking lot first thing, 40 years from now. Okay, we need a motion on this in a second. Vicki, you already got it worded as it goes, so somebody's
30 days on it.
30 day deal, somebody pop up with a motion. Your name will never be known.
Why are y'all looking at me? Okay, I make the motion.
All right. Mr. McDonald, make the motion. Motion made by Mr. McDonald. And second by?
I second.
Mr. Johnny Munson.
Yes, sir.
All right, now
okay, when everybody comes after me, y'all better, I'm gonna remember it was here.
And all in favor?
They know where I live.
Yes. I got your back.
All opposed? Thank you very much. I think you made a wise decision and a big step there. And I think the citizens appreciate
it. Happens.
That's what should have been done.
That took forever.
42 minutes ago. That's all. Yeah. Gave us time to think it over.
Will this be in a contract with form or?
Yeah. Have to be.
With
Johnny.
And I'll go talk to Nancy tomorrow and tell him what we come up with. And that may end it right there.
We got these ones.
Yeah, mine.
Very well.
I got something. Before we go on to any further business, does anybody have anything in the audience that you'd like to say? Anybody have anything to bring up? Yes, sir.
Yeah, my name is Dave Washington, and I'm the chairman of the McEwen Farmers Market here with Jerry Pangle, vice chairman, and we just wanted to address the council members and the mayor and introduce ourselves and in the community and just see if there's any problems, any questions. You know, our hopes is to continue this next year and potentially even open it up to like 2 days a week next year. So, does anybody have any questions?
Like, thank you guys for letting us do this.
Yes, I don't absolutely. Think there's been a problem one. I think y'all handled everything and done a great job.
I've enjoyed it.
Great.
I've enjoyed it.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
So just let us know if there's any questions, and thank you very much.
Thank you. For coming. Thank you much.
My name is Alvin. Most everybody knows me here in town. I have been approached several times on several different occasions in the last 2 to 3 weeks about the people having swimming pools, which everybody knows I'm a swimming pool dealer here in town. Have been for 35 years now. And most recently, I had two people this week that has approached me why they had to pay city sewer on water that never hit the sewer that they used to do in their pool. So I've done a little research on all the cities around the borders of McEwen, Johnsonville, Waverly, Camden, and Dixon. And I'd like to pass those out to y'all to look at. And this is what they told us today. I just want the board to look at that to see what could be done about that. As y'all know, we have to pay sewer rates on the water. And a lot of that never hits the... I know Fairview told us today that they have a bunch of meters in that particular city where they used to water their grass, their lawns, and whatever. Dixon County, they have meters on their hydrants that they put. It's universal where they can move them from one spout to the other, and they read that particular meter, and that's what they charge the water for. They also have a separate meter that they can put in the ground, and my understanding is they have a meter that's teed, and one goes to one, and then the other one goes to the house. And if the one that goes to the house is on, that's where you pay the city sewer. If they got the one going through, like you're putting in your swimming pool or watering your lawn or washing your car or whatever, that goes through. And that's what they do. Now, I know some people probably may run a hose through their kitchen and probably wash their clothes or something, but I don't know if that's ever happened. But I told these people that I would confront the board to see if there's anything they could do to relieve some of the pressure from the sewer that when they put, and incidentally, Dixon County allows one fill up a year for a new pool, whether it's 30,000, 24,000 or whatever, they allow one fill up. And then from then on, if they have a leak in the pool or whatever, if you bring them the documentation where they actually fix the pool, then they will relieve the sewer off of that particular bill also. Something that I'd like for y'all to take a look at. And y'all have the cities that what they do and how they go about it in our surrounding city.
So you talked to all these today?
I did not personally, but Linda did. She did. She talked to everyone. And the numbers that she called is on your paper there. These were the people that were in the water department, I guess, or whatever. I know one fellow told me that he had over a $300 water bill, and he said, man, he said, it shouldn't have been that because I had to pay a lot of sewer on top of that. And then he got to tell me, I forgot I left the pool run over down the hill one night. So, you know, that's his, you know, I've done that before too. So I can't make anything for that.
Well, this is something that was done how many years ago?
2009.
Okay. I didn't know exactly when it happened or when they started doing the rates.
Of course, I got a pool and I didn't like it either, still don't, but I've got nothing in this whatsoever. So.
Well, I brought it up to several people. I've talked to several people about that over the past few years, and nobody seems to care. Nobody at that time seemed to care. So I thought, well, since these people are jumping me, as a pool man and wanting to know, well, why are we doing this? I don't have the answer, so I'll just go to the board and let them look at it. And see if you can do anything or open for suggestions on how you want to approach it or if you want to do anything or whatever.
Well, you know, you've taken the right step, come before the board. That's what the board and the mayor, that's what we're here for. For the citizens to come, and if you got a problem or just voice an opinion or whatever, you've taken the first step. Now, has anybody got any ideas about this? Anybody want to change anything? Anybody want to look into it?
I got an idea. I mean, just based on like the Dixon thing, what if you had a one-time yearly exemption per resident per swimming pool? And if this gentleman oversees the filling, he could...
But say I'm not the only pool dealer. That, yeah, I mean, I'm the only pool dealer here, period.
But see, you can be the exclusive one.
I got to look on my agenda right now.
Oh, I feel a kickback coming.
All right, well, let the other pool dealers do it too. At least they, you know, they could say that they filled so and so's pool on such and such a date. They read the beer.
Well, it used to be that way. It used to, when back before, I guess you said 2009, Vicki. It used to that what we did is we read the meter and then, well, as we was filling the pool, then we reported back to Jane, told her, hey, we've got 24,000 gallons in this guy's pool. And that was it. Then she took that off the wheel, you know, or whatever.
Miss so, Jane used to pretty yeah. well figure, didn't she?
Just the sewer.
Well, it was just water at that time. There's no sewer on it. Then the sewer got put on it, and then, you know, that's when everybody's getting the complaints.
They always paid for the water usage.
Yes.
Jane used to adjust the sewer.
Yes.
To their average.
So
the reason Clyde stopped it was because we had people coming in here, and we were giving adjustments, and we later found out they didn't even have a pool.
That's right.
And they wanted adjustments for watering their flowers.
If that's what the board wants to do, tell them to come to see me, and I will. I will be glad to go out and do that if it means that to the city. Say, hey, yeah, they do have a pool, and they had a problem, and we had to drain it, fill it. I know I've had numerous. And Cecil probably can vouch for this, but I've had numerous problems with my pool this year where I've had to add water to it, and in fact, you're right back out on waste to get rid of the junk that was in it. That's neither, you know, sometimes that happens and sometimes it don't. Some of the pools that I service never had that first drop of green in them, and others have just gotten green as gourds, you know, so.
Yeah, I think another reason it was eliminated was for watering gardens and yards.
They would come in and their bill would just be up like 1,000 gallons and we were having to adjust. And that's why he did it, because it got out of hand.
I don't know what they're paying in Dixon County. I don't know what they pay for their meters or whatever, but I know there's a couple of pools that I service in Dixon, and they actually have the meter that looks just like ours, only it's retrofit to go on through their hydrant with a little pigtail hose. And that's what they run the water through, whether they're washing their car or watering their lawn or whatever. And that particular water gets just water, no sewer.
Yeah, but what you're talking about is pool water. You're not talking about washing the car, watering the lawn.
Yeah, in this instance, we're just talking about pool water. I haven't, people want to water their lawn on lawns. They can gripe about that if they want to, but I'm just talking about swimming pools.
But if the you just had a meter that hooked, you talk about a meter that hooked on your hydrant?
Yes.
Hook a hose to it and use that to fill the pool. Well, then people would be watering the garden and watering
the garden. Well, that's what I'm saying.
I know they
can
water
money. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they can do that. But I'm saying that's the way they do it in Dixon County. They do have a separate meter that they run that water through with that sewer.
The only way I see that would work is a way to make sure it went in the pool.
Yeah, that's true.
So Alvin can monitor it, right?
I can, if that's what we need to do. And if Vicki has a, say, hey, you need to go look at this, we've got a bill for a customer that's got it, I don't mind going by and look and make sure they got a pool and it's legit.
What type of pool, I mean, You know how many booths are in the end? I mean, you got kids' booths, and then you got...
Those at Walmart, right.
You got in-ground booths.
They're more...
Larry, we're not talking about your kiddie pool.
Well, we have to do cross-connection inspections on booths to start with, so, you know, there's quite... One time, there's a bunch of booths.
There's a lot of them here.
McEwen got their share.
You get them little... Bullet pool, 2,000 gallon pool every month or add water to them.
Well, my 24,000 gallon pool, I've had to add quite a bit of water to it this year too. So, hey, it's just, you know, it just depends on the weather and stuff that we have too. So
you'd have to define it because you got people with hot tubs and then your oil filter.
A hot tub has 450, 400.
Greg, you have to define the criteria, because if you don't, you know, Vicky's going to be fighting people off all day long. So, you have to define what it is, whether it's a certain gallon, and it's only, you're only talking about the sewer exemption, they're still going to pay for the water usage, right?
Yes.
Which, does that make sense? I mean, if you're not putting down the sewer, that makes logical sense.
Hey, you can put a limit. 400 gallons or less, you don't have that right? Or 500 gallons above or more gets an exemption?
I would just say if somebody didn't sign off on it, or, you know, like somebody monitoring it, like if you didn't sign off on some, sure they'd be liable for it.
Yeah.
You got to define it though, because you don't want someone coming in and saying, geez, I got my kiddie pool and I filled it up 10 times. Right? So you have to just define it so that there's no gray area.
Right.
Because otherwise someone comes back and say, well, we let them do it, but how come I can't do it? So you just have to define the criteria and then move on.
I would say the Walmart blow-up pools, they're not a system-run pool.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to empty them every other day to keep fresh water in
right.
the kit.
Right.
I would say anything that had a filtering system on it, that you filtered the water, that would be the pools that would be exempt for them. If they didn't have a filtering system on them, then any pool,
you
couldn't do it. So just, I mean, y'all got my list that we did today, so you can think about it or take some action on it or whatever.
Well, now we can find out who's got pool, you know, that filtered pool, you know. We can make a list.
I used to have it.
You think you still got it? Well, there might be some in here.
There's a bunch of addings or cracking on. Like I said, we used to cross things and go inspect the pool. And if somebody wanted us to go look at it, I could do a cross connection. That would kill two birds with one stone, you know. If they wanted to adjust them, we could go look at it. Go from there.
That's been a sore spot with a lot of people for many years. I can see why Mr. Adams did it, because, you know, people were pulling stuff. But I think we can regulate it too, like Mr. Holland said here. Filtered pool, you know, with filters and everything. And he can, you know, like we can, the city employee, Larry doesn't mind, he'll go by, and I guarantee you, he'll go by in everybody's yard if they got a pool.
Yeah, like if they come in want adjustment, I'll go do a crop connection inspection. That's something we have to do with the state anyway.
Well, they've been tied to one a year.
Yeah.
To a filtering system.
Make sure they got a hole stick in that pipe so it don't suck back into the system.
Exactly.
I do think that the reason that they did that in Dixon to get the one-time pool is so many people up there that they get that one-time thing to fill it up, but that doesn't mean you should get that next year because 95% of the time or 99% of the time you're not going to drain them every year. That's supposed to. And then you've got a problem.
That'd be one way to do it. Mm-hmm. Well, everybody's seen what Mr. Holland has presented. Everybody's heard what we talked about. Anybody got any ideas? You want to take any kind of action whatsoever? He made some good points, as did Mr. As did Larry here. So, anybody got any ideas about this subject? Poor Dennis couldn't make a living here pulling teeth.
We'd have to have, like the gentleman back there recommended, that'd have to be a definition of a pool defined, and that would be one, as Mr. Holland recommended, one that would have a filtered system on it. That's obvious. And another thing was if they had a leak and came in and asked for an adjustment, that it should be accompanied a bill from a licensed business that does pool repair. That's reasonable.
Yes.
And then if they have a fill up with a sewer waived, they'd be limited to one a year. And then when that happened, Larry would inspect the pool for cross contamination purposes and to see that it was filled up.
Exactly.
And that's reasonable. That's reasonable.
I agree with that.
We'll be charging them for the water. We'd be waiving the sewer rate once a year. And it would have to be a filtered system. Make sure everybody understands that. And if you had a leak, and Mr. Holland will tell you their pools are going to leak, and I'm sure he fixes them a lot.
He tries.
They'd have to come in and with a bill, invoice from Mr. Holland or whoever else dug in the pool business. And then once a year, we'd do the inspection with Mr. Johnson when they called in for the sewer to be waived for the pool fill, that he would go out and inspect it and do the cross-contamination inspection and then certify it back to the city recorder it was done. And then the way that I would think that you would need to adjust it would be by adjustment made on the sewer by using the sewer's monthly average and then take that off for that particular month that they filled it up for that sewer. Take that much off of the sewer,
right.
The additional amount that was on that bill that they normally wouldn't have been paying.
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen back there got something to say, man.
So the only thing I think of is how you make sure that it's not like an opportunity for constant leaking to occur. Uh-huh. Right? So you have to put in something to say, look, this is not going to continue to happen, so it's not leaking every single month. Right?
Yeah.
They would have to have it fixed to repair it in order to get that.
Right.
And you'd have to bring the city the bill, and the city would have to know that it's been fixed and signed off on. So now if it develops another leak, which they do that occasionally, you know,
that would help the people in town that have the pool almost a year, when especially in spring, we go to fill it up.
Right.
And that's.
Now they have a 20,000 gallon pool. They don't have 50,000 gallons to their meter because they left it on all night and run out on the yard. That's going to have to make something for that right there.
Yeah, sure, mercy, that's
hard.
I've been there.
No. If the water, if they leave it running, they don't pay for it.
People like me are dumb enough to leave it running all night, they just have to pay for it. Mm-hmm.
But that's what I would think would be reasonable to do.
I agree.
You'll make it in the form of motion, and we'll have to get Johnny to draw all this up.
I'll make that in the form of a motion. I've explained it twice.
I second.
Motion been made and seconded. I mean in a hurry. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much.
Should we go?
Anybody else have anything?
I'm Sonia, and there is an alleyway that runs between property and my neighbor's property that has not been used in God knows how long, many years, probably since my great grandparents lived there. And I'm here today asking for a quick claim to the alleyway so that I can get it cleaned up and because there was a bunch of broken trees back there that the ice storms had taken out, and I want all that stuff cleaned up to make, because it's making my property look bad, having all this back behind it.
How about the lady behind you there? Is what she say about it? She want a part of it, or she didn't want anything?
I haven't heard anything from her.
Well, she needs to be checked with. We usually give half of the alley to the one on where the property divide, the property line is, there's alley there. They get half of it, and the other property owner gets half of it. And the person is responsible for all costs with the survey that they have to do.
Ms. Costa did come in and ask me about it, and that's all she did was ask what would happen with it. She didn't give it away.
So that, I have gone back there and talked to her about it. And of course, this was before the meeting of last month that Mr. Ross asked me to come this month, and she seemed kind of interested about it, but yet she didn't say for sure that, you know, 100% sure that she would.
And we haven't, and the city hasn't done anything to that alleyway at all.
No
work has been done.
Nothing.
Why don't you check with the other property owner and ask her to come to the next meeting. If you come with her, we'll come back before the board, and then we can address it at that time. But we can't take no action on that until we talk to the other property owner.
Okay.
That's not fair to that person.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, thank you.
Anybody else have any? Okay, thank you. All right, last month we voted on three ordinances. We were told we were allowed to do it, so now we need to pass them. We need to get a motion and a second. Ordinance number 285, and it is for commercial garbage rates, to raise the commercial garbage rates, which has been done. We need a motion and a second.
Motion.
Motion been made to approve the raising of the garbage rates, commercial garbage rates. By second.
Second.
Motion been made and second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
Okay. Ordinance number.
Thank you. Order number 286.
That ordinance number we just passed was 285.
285. I said 285.
Yeah.
You hard again? 286 is court cost. That's already been done too, but we need to make a motion and second and pass this. Anybody want to make a motion?
I'll make a motion.
Motion been made.
Second.
Motion been second to pass ordinance 286. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much. 287. It's the ordinance to add or put Good Friday back on as a holiday.
Motion.
Motion been made to add it back.
Second.
Second's been made to add it back. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much. That needed to be done right there. Get it in. Okay, next thing in the order is the tornado siren on Pine Thicket Road. Remember when Lewis came up, took the siren down. The siren is now down to the sewer plant being worked on. The tornado siren down at the sewer plant, the reason it would not go off without manually going down there and setting it off is because the transmitter was too low. It's well, really, you can reach it by hand. But Merrill Lewis will not do that for us because we're going to have coax. So we're in the process now of getting Gentry Mechanical to raise that up higher up to the top of the pole so it will pick up without having to go down there and manually do it. Because we don't need city workers or anybody else out in the tornado trying to set off a tornado sign. So
that's good.
That's old business that's going to be taken care of. Next thing is some land over here next to the railroad tracks. It's the North Railroad across from Tommy Parchman's house. I talked to Mr. John Lee Williams. Mr. Parchman's interested in it. Mr. John Lee Williams said we must declare it surplus property, and then we'll have to take bids on it. So we need to take action on that now.
any known municipal use, future municipal use for the property?
No, sir, not whatsoever. There's no way to use anything there. The man's been mowing, keeping it up now.
Is this the property that we got years ago from the railroad?
Yeah. Right there between Tommy's and the railroad. It's McEwen, the city has a little section there in between the two properties and where we keep gravel and stuff. And they, people that are interested in it, have agreed to let us keep that. They don't want that. All they want to do is keep get the rest. One man wants to put a garden out, and the other just wants to keep it mowed. So we'll have bids on it.
By declaring surplus, we'll have to take the bidding on it.
Yeah, we'll have to take bidding on it. We had a gentleman that offered to write me a check that day for it when I talked to him. He wanted both of them, but it doesn't work that way. So we need to declare the surplus.
Being no municipal, future municipal use for it, then I would make a motion to declare it surplus, subject to sale laws.
Motion been made to declare it surplus, so we can sell it. And like I say, we will keep the strip where the gravel and all is stored now. The city's property, then we will keep it.
Second.
Motion been made, second. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you much. Another great job. Okay, just to give you a little update, everybody, the board and everybody here, our city workers put a new roof on the extension to the concession stand out here to Junior League, Junior Pro football field. That is the city park. So it cost us $463.71 in materials and man hours, which the men were going to work 8 hours a piece anyway. So just let you know what has been done. It needs to be done. Like I say, it is a city park, so we had no choice but to fix it. It was caving in. The city employees took out the old rusted culvert on Parish Lane. I think most people are aware of that. It was a 6-foot by 40-foot culvert. And it was predicted, or somebody predicted it on Facebook, to take a week. It took just barely 3 days, not hardly 3 days to get it done. We still lack some cleanup. But they worked hard and did a great job on it. And that the culvert was a cost of $2,970. And that's delivered. Now the other culvert that we used to make a temporary road was donated by the county. We called them and asked them if they could donate, let us borrow one. And they did. And it wasn't worn out either. Pretty good culvert. Now whether they want it back, we don't know yet. If we don't, we're looking for a place to store it. Anybody got a good backyard, you know. A fire hydrant on Hargis Road in 231 has come to question. It has been ordered. The lady's insurance is paying for it. I think it's around $1,800, isn't it, Vicki? Something like that. And we're waiting. Her insurance will pay for it. Wait for it to come in. I think so. I think we've already received a check, right?
We have on one, waiting on the other.
On the other one, on High Street Bridge Road, right? Mm-hmm. We're waiting on. I don't know what's going to happen with the insurance on that.
She was supposed to check on that. I talked to her Friday or Thursday.
But the first thing we do is try to get the insurance companies to pay. But if not, we'll take care of it. We're not going to let a fire hydrant go. We need them. We did get a $5,000 grant for money from the UT Extension Service, thanks to Miss Karen Davis, who is not here tonight. I'd like to thank her. That's for the city park out here, for the playground equipment. Vicki, Miss Moran, excuse me, Mrs. Moran, that lady hiding back there in the hole back there, Miss Angie Baker, and myself looked through catalogs, and they decided, we decided on playground equipment to order. We ordered equipment with donations that Mr. Michael Hooper has taken up. We have enough money to get the equipment that we want. It's going to cost, I think, $6,200, I believe that's right. And if we wait 3 weeks, they'll put it up for us free. And we're not in that big a hurry. We wait 3 weeks, free setup. But it's nice new equipment. There's no wood to it at all. It's going to be really nice. And we're also looking at another grant. I'm working with a gentleman now to get a walking trail going into the woods and coming out of the woods out behind the baseball field, behind the junior pro football field. It will be lighted. It will be paved. It'll be a paved surface, not concrete, but paved. Lighted with benches set, I don't know what distance, but we will determine that so people can take a break. And it will be lighted. And the park is still locked up at 10, so you know everything's in good shape there. But that grant, I think it's going to go through. I don't think we'll have any trouble with that. And we have a committee for the playground, or for the city park, excuse me. And that's Mr. Jimmy Etheridge, Ms. Kim Moultrie, Mr. Basil Hooper, Mrs. Ann Ross, Wanda McNeil, Ms. Heather Legan, who is Mr. Larry Mayberry's daughter. And these people, which I guess Mr. Etheridge would be the head, I think is the head, would consider the head of the committee. Mr. Etheridge, you need to get a hold of your people for this committee here, and we need to get together, and we need to do some groundwork before this playground equipment comes in. I'll bring my tractor out because the city workers look like they'll be busy. But we got the dimensions of what we need and everything, and I don't think it'll take over a day to do it. And we're going to ask for volunteers from anybody that's willing to help. Mike has worked hard on this, taking up donations. He's got down and worked hard. I'm filling out paperwork now to DuPont to get a donation. And as you just will as the president, I think. But maybe they'll give $15. They're hard up, I tell you. I don't know how many city employees are here now. I know Mr. Larry Johnson, I think it may be the only one here tonight. I don't think Houston made it. We've been going to Nashville most of the day, so he didn't make it back, but I want to thank you for all your hard work. Larry, I want to say a special thank you to you. Would you stand up, please, so people can see who you are at one time and get a good, clear shot? Mr. Johnson here took it upon himself. It was mentioned, I guess I mentioned it sometime, that we need to paint the fire hydrant. Next thing I know, got paint everywhere. He painted 127 fire hydrants on his own.
Wow.
And that's all we got in McEwen. And of course, when we put these two new ones back in service, he'll paint them. And we need a second coat, by the way, Larry.
I'll paint a second.
But we really do appreciate it very much. You did a great job. That's really all I have. We've covered a lot, and I think we've accomplished a lot tonight. And I appreciate you ladies and Johnny, John, everybody taking part. And all the citizens, I appreciate you coming, I appreciate you taking part and being patient with us. I would like to recognize a person that came tonight, and that's Mr. Matthew Johnson. He's from our engineering firm working with us.
Thank you for the donuts.
I want to give a brief update.
Oh yeah, sure. I'm sorry.
I won't take too long. Just briefly, the project that we just started at the wastewater plant, we're working through the submittal process. Contractor's not actually on site yet. He's done a little bit of investigative work out, but he probably won't get started fully until about another week or two. He's waiting on some materials to get in. I've reached out to the state, to TDEC, about a meeting to talk about some of those deadlines that I mentioned at the last meeting. They're coming up at the end of the year, just to talk about getting an extension on those. Haven't heard back yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you guys know so we get that scheduled. And then the last thing, I think some of you may already be aware, the rural development grant loan package. They have all the materials in, so you know, it's just a matter of getting working through the approval process, and then we can get started with the major work in town that's still remaining. So, told you to be brief, so any questions on
those items.
What, do we have a chance at any taps at all whatsoever?
Well, that'll be part of the conversation with TDEC. I think like we talked about before, since they know we're starting some work down at the plant and we're getting the rural development grant loan in place, they can see the city's making an effort, concerted effort to meet the requirements of the order. And I think they'll, like they've done in the past, I think they'll be willing to give out a few taps. How many, I don't know, but that'll just be part of the conversation when we meet with them.
Well, we have a gentleman here that wants to build some medium housing apartments. Mm. He's going to get on the ball really fast. He's a contractor, and he's a good one. He's a local fellow. So we'll just do what we can. We'll do what we can. We'll ask for him anyway.
If you've got an idea before we go in there on how many taps you'd like, that's probably, it'd be good to have a number ahead of time.
That's so a good idea.
Okay.
We'll ask for it.
All right.
We'll take what we can, but we'll ask for it.
Yeah, okay. Any other questions? Hopefully next month we'll have some actual construction going on at the plant. There'll be more to update you guys on. So.
Thank you, Matthew.
I appreciate you informed. Thank you.
Good work. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good job.
Thanks.
One other thing I'd like to do real quick, because I don't know if Chief Jernigan is still here or not. Yeah. I'd like to thank Chief Jernigan and his officers. They've done a fine job down at the sewer plant. We had a lot of surplus vehicles and a lot of scrap metal and just a lot of junk that has accumulated over the years. And he has taken his men and Mr. Michael Pate, Mr. Hooper, and who else, Mr. Jernigan? Who's Bob? Anyway, they have sold just about everything that they can sell. They even sold these two doors that came down from the inside here. I think they brought $50 or something like that.
$72.
So, $72 for two doors.
I did a quick numbers thing before the meeting started. And so far we've sold right at $20,000, brought in $20,000, and $10,000 of that goes to the general fund revenue, another half to go in the drug fund. And we've got some more items still up for auction now.
The dozer, is it still at $62,500?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And it goes till Thursday. We're anticipating it going up some more.
Boy, you'd like to have that one. thank you very much. I appreciate it. You all have done a great job getting down there and working.
Oh, yes, sir. And also, I assume that the we're selling one bulldozer, but we did replace it with another bulldozer.
Yeah, they did get us another dozer. It hadn't got a cab on it. It's quite a bit cooler. And it's got a winch on it that brought that big 6-foot by 40-foot cover down the ground. It was moaning and groaning, the cover would, but it brought it out.
We've also got another truck coming that we can share with the utility department. It's an F-150.
And you got us another dump truck.
Yes, sir. We've got another dump truck. It needs a little work, but I think it's going to be fine.
We got three and we got one working.
Yes, sir.
We'll look for more. You've done a great job. Thank you all very much.
Yes, sir.
And that's about all. Anybody else got anything at all? Mr. Etheridge, you're going to get a hold of your bunch and get them together. Give me a call. We'll all meet out there and see what we need to do. And Mr. Trooper, you're going to be in on that. Every member of the board, I appreciate you very much. I appreciate it. We had a good meeting. We got some things accomplished tonight. That's what we need to do. I appreciate it.
We had a lot of good discussion.
Yeah.
And we had good feedback from the citizens.
Citizens. We always want, that's why we ask for citizens to come. Is feedback. Everybody get a good idea. Mr. Hendricks, Mr. Hooper, everybody. Does anybody have anything else? If not.
Anybody got anything?
Motion's been made to adjourn at 7:24.
My second.
She may go back to Florida. She just comes back for the meeting. Motion's been made and seconded. All in favor? All right. 7:24.